Blaze is a mama's boy. He is so sweet and he is so smart. I didn't find out Blaze was deaf until we got out of the NICU.
I actually did Blaze's initial hearing screening when he was in the hospital in the NICU here at UVA.
When they told me that he had failed the screening test, I said, so what does that mean?
We don't know with 100% certainty why Blaze is deaf, but Blaze was born 25 weeks. He was born premature.
We have a pretty significant cochlear implant candidacy process because it's not an easy decision. We believe that they deserve to have resources. We believe that they need to have all the information to be able to make the decision that's right for their particular child. Blaze's hearing loss was severe enough to deem him a cochlear implant candidate because we knew hearing aids probably would not work for him.
Blaze is a twin and we are a speaking family, so I feel like him not being able to hear us and would alienate him.
They wanted us to try out the hearing aids, and then when we came back, discussed it, and then that's when it was just decided upon.
Cochlear implants are one of the engineering marvels of the 21st and 20th century. The implant collects sound and turns that sound energy into an electrical signal. Cochlear implant surgery takes about 2 hours. It's an outpatient procedure, so the child comes to the hospital, has the surgery, and can go home the same day.
Which was surprising. I was under the impression that we were gonna have to at least stay the night. He bounced back so fast, it was incredible.
Once the bandage comes off, there's a small incision shaped like an S, tucked in behind the ear and up into the hairline. About 3 to 4 weeks after surgery, the patient comes back to audiology for the activation of the cochlear implant. And if you've ever seen a cochlear implant activation, it is a very powerful and moving experience.